Returning to the cobbles after 15 years away, Canadian businessman Stephen Reed, played by Todd Boyce, set his sights on stealing Mum Audrey Roberts, Sue Nichols, money. However, things quickly went downhill when his cunning ways were threatened to be exposed, resulting in him taking multiple lives in order to keep his secrets hidden. With it being a year since he arrived back in Weatherfield, Express.co.uk have taken a look back at the people he's killed, the lies he's told and the plans still unfolding. When Leo Tompkins, Joe Frost, discovered Stephen was trying to defraud Audrey in order to pay back his ex-wife Gabrielle, Helene Moxud, he decided to confront him, threatening to tell everyone the truth, including the police. An altercation broke out between the two men as they argued on the top floor of the factory outside. Attacking Leo in a fit of rage, Stephen pushed his head onto a meal barrier before pushing him off the edge to his death. Trying to cover his tracks, the killer pretended to be Leo as he messaged people off of his phone, making it seem he was still alive and well. However, the murderer made it seem as though Leo decided to move to Canada alone, leaving Jenny Connor, Sally Ann Matthews, heartbroken that her boyfriend had left her behind. Burning his things to try and cover his tracks, Stephen seemed to be in the clear until Leo's father Teddy Tompkins, Grant Bergen, made his way onto the cobbles looking for his son, discovering that his son had never made it to Canada. Teddy made it his mission to try and get to the bottom of where he was. Growing suspicious of Stephen, the killer started to get concerned his secret would be revealed. Although when Teddy was involved in a car accident, he got a lucky escape as he confessed to not remembering a thing. However, this was short-lived and Teddy was adamant Stephen had something to do with Leo's disappearance and headed to Underworld to confront him. Demanding answers, Stephen was insistent he knew nothing, but Teddy wasn't convinced and threatened to call the police. Panicking, Stephen grabbed the heaviest thing he could find and whacked him over the head with a hole punch, ultimately killing him. Don't miss Coronation Street's Eveline's absence explained as daughter Cassie arrives. Insight: Coronation Street fans demand resident needs to go after Roy Cropperswipe. Reaction: Claire Sweeney unrecognizable as she plays heroin addict in Coronation Street. So, putting his body into Audrey's car roof box, ITV fans watched in horror as he dumped Eddie into a lake, getting away with murder twice. With Leo and Teddy out of the way, Stephen continued his new plan to try and take over the factory and oust Carla Connor, Allison King, out. Trying to make her appear incapable, he had been secretly drugging her tea with LSD, which was soon discovered by businessman Rufus Donahue, Steve Mayo. As Rufus started to blackmail Stephen in a bid to keep his spiking a secret, the killer obeyed his demands for weeks until he reached the end of his tether. In a flashback scene, Stephen took some LSD with him to Rufus' house to spike him while they spoke about business. When Rufus started to feel the drugs sink in, Stephen took his opportunity to get rid of him by holding his head under the pool and killing him. So far in his year of terror, Stephen has claimed the lives of three people and has now set his sights on fiancé Elaine Jones, Paula Wilcox. Realizing she has a lot of money, Stephen took out life insurance for his bride-to-be after learning she had a heart condition that killed her mum. Swapping her blood pressure medication with caffeine pills, Elaine passed out in recent scenes with Stephen walking out believing she was dead. However, when she came to, it was clear his plan didn't work as her son Tim Metcalf, Joe Duttine, started to become wary of Stephen's actions. Could Elaine become the fourth victim in Stephen Reed's killer year? Coronation Street continued Mondays, Wednesdays and Fridays on ITV from 8 p.m.